Arts, Science and Commerce College, Maguli, Pune. Today I am going to talk on bird adaptation. So what is adaptation? That is the main theme of this topic. So adaptation means any change in the morphology of the animal or any change in the anatomy of the animal. That change, which this change is helpful for these animals to live in that particular environment. So that change is known as adaptation. Birds, you know, the birds are highly specialized animals. They are structurally as well as, it means morphological as well as anatomical modifications are there in the bird's body, and that's because of that actually the birds, they live on the trees as well as they take a good flight. So the birds are highly specialized animals, and they show their all the body parts internally as well as externally. They are highly modified, they are changed. For example, beak, feet, wings, tail, these are all modified organs seen only in the birds, not in other animals. Now if we see the bird body, then the bird's body is divided into a neck, then a head, then neck, then this part is known as abdomen or trunk region. Trunk region is again divided into thoracic region as well as abdominal region, and a small tail is present. So bird's body is divided into head, neck, trunk and tail. In the head region, a lightweight beak is present. Jaws are modified into beak. In the birds, teeth are absent. Teeth are heavyweight, and so these animals, they take a flight, so weight reduction is important, and that's why teeth are absent. Eyes are large, okay, so vision is good in the birds, so eyes are large. Nostrils are there, then the brain case skull is present, which is made of cartilage as well as bones. Then a neck is there, neck, highly mobile neck is present or found in the birds. So neck connects the head region to the trunk region. Trunk region divides into two parts, the upper thoracic, anterior thoracic and posterior abdominal region. In the birds, actually in the animals, four limbs and hind limbs are present, but in the birds, four limbs are modified into wings. So four limbs, the bones which are present in the four limbs, they are internally supported the wings. These wings are provided with the muscles. These muscles, actually two type of muscles are there. The first muscles are known as pectoralis major and second pectoralis minor. These muscles, they provide the strength or they provide energy to the wings. Then the only two hind limbs are useful for walking, jumping, perching. These hind limbs are shifted towards the center of the body to balance the body. Actually, this is the necessary adaptation. So the hind limbs are shifted towards the center of the body. So hind limbs are very well developed. Each hind limb having four digits or four toes. Out of these four toes, the one toe is backwardly directed and three toes are forwardly directed. So this arrangement is useful for perching or for holding the branch. Then a tail is present. In the modern bird, internally only 13 vertebrae or less than 13 vertebrae, caudal vertebrae are present, and all these vertebrae, they fuse to form the bagospine, and then the externally this tail is covered by the wings, the feathers. These feathers are known as tail feathers. Okay. So some important features are seen in the bird's body. The first important feature, that is the shape of the body. The body is perfectly streamlined. So what is the meaning of streamlined body? Streamlined body means anterior end of the body is pointed. Similarly, the posterior end is also pointed, and the middle portion is broader. So anterior end to posterior end, such body shape is known as streamlined. And bird's body is perfectly streamlined body. Such body or such shape affords minimum resistance to the air. Then the second important feature is compact body. Compact body. So compact body means body is arranged compactly. At the ventral side of the body, heavy organs are present. For example, alimentary canal, then gonads, kidneys, they are located at the ventral side. And at the dorsal side of the body, the light organs are there. And these light organs, for example, lungs are there. And lungs are always filled with the air. So the lungs are present. In the birds, again, air bladders are present. So air bladders and lungs, they are located at the dorsal side, and this is helpful for balancing the body in the air. The third feature is body covering of the feathers. The complete body of the bird is covered by the feathers. All the feathers, they are smooth, they are closely fitting, backwardly directed, and again the body, it becomes compact. Now these feathers, you know, the birds are warm-blooded animals, so these feathers, they are non-conductor of the heat, and that's why the body remains warm because of the feathers. So that is the first important feature, important function of the feathers. The second important thing which is related to the feather, that is in between the feathers, the external air is trapped, and because of this air trapping, the body, it becomes lightweight, and then these animals, they take a flight. So that is the second thing. And the third thing which is related to the feather, and that is again helpful for the birds, that is the feathers. Means the wings are covered by the long feathers. The wings are covered by the long feathers, and these long feathers, they maintain the body shape, body remains compact. The next fourth important thing is four limbs are modified into wings. So four limbs, in the birds, only bipedal locomotion is there. Two legs are used for walking, jumping, as well as for running, perching, etc. And the four limbs are completely modified into wings. These four limbs are provided with the two types of muscle, pectoralis major and pectoralis minor. These muscles, they provide energy for the flight. At the resting time, the wings, they remain folded against the sides of the body, and during the flight, these wings, they are completely expanded. Wings are completely expanded, and see here, this edge of the wing is known as leading edge, and leading edge is somewhat convex. So convex leading edge, and this posterior edge is convex. So convex leading edge and the posterior edge is concave. Such body shape or such wing shape is useful for flight. So it helps in driving the bird forwardly, upwardly during the flight. Then the next feature is neck is mobile. In the birds, the neck is mobile. The birds, they can move their neck in 180 degree. So that is the special adaptation seen only in the birds. So mobile neck is there. A very long flexible neck is present in the birds. Mobility and freedom, it is due to the vertebrae which are present in the neck region. The beak is lightweight. The jaws are modified into lightweight beak. The beak is useful for feeding, for preening, for nest building, for offense as well as defense. Teeth are absent in the jaws. The birds, they show bipedal locomotion, means they use only the hind limbs for locomotion, so bipedal locomotion. Perching means with the help of hind limbs and with the help of the four toes. Out of these four toes, three toes are forwardly directed, one toe is backwardly directed. Such arrangement is helpful for perching. Then in the modern birds, the tail is short, and the short tail is internally supported by 13 or less than 13 caudal vertebrae. All these caudal vertebrae, they fuse to form the phagocyte, and that's why the tail in the modern birds, tail is short. And this short tail externally is covered by the feathers. These feathers may be short feathers or long feathers. For example, you know, in the peacock, long feathers are present, tail feathers are long. Next feature, anatomical adaptation. So, first we saw all the morphological adaptations. Now the anatomical adaptation means internal adaptations, internal modifications. Now in that, the first one is endoskeleton. So endoskeleton is important thing. Now endoskeleton means the body is internally supported by the bones. Now all these bones in the birds, majority of the bones, mostly the bones are pneumatic bones. Pneumatic bones means internally these bones are filled with the air instead of bone marrow. In the long bones, bone marrow is present, but all these remaining, most of the bones, they have air inside the bones, and that's why the body is lightweight. Then the skull bone is paper-like, means it is thin, it is spongy, teeth are absent, beak is lightweight beak is present, thoracic vertebrae, except the last one, they are fused, so it provides the rigidity. Sternum is T-shaped, and short caudal vertebrae and hind limbs bones help to strengthen the bipedal locomotion. The next about the digestive system. In the birds, metabolic rate is high. Okay, metabolic rate is high in the birds. The food requirement or food demand is also great. Digestion is rapid. Rectum is short, fecal matter is small. So rectum is short means there is no need of storage of the fecal matter in the rectum, and that's why the rectum is short and fecal matter is small. spongy lungs are there. Lungs are well developed, they are spongy, they are larger in size, they are expandable, and in plus, besides the lungs, here air bladders are also present. 5 air bladders are present in the bird, and these air bladders are also full with the air. So the body becomes lightweight because of these air filled lungs and air bladder, and plus the air bladder, they supply fresh oxygen supply to the body. And the lungs as well as air bladder, they lie or they are situated at the dorsal side of the animal. Then the next thing is warm-bloodedness. Only the birds as well as mammals, they are warm-blooded, means they maintain their body temperature, they are homeotherms. So the aeration of the blood becomes rapid and they maintain their body temperature. This is the alimentary canal of the bird, beak, then the buccal cavity. This is pharynx, esophagus, this is crop. In the crop, sometimes the birds, they store the grains or seeds, etc. And then the next part is stomach. Now this is the gizzard. In the gizzard, what happens? The larger food particles or seeds, grains, they are broken down into smaller forms. Then this is intestine, these are the intestinal cicae. A small rectum is there, and then the cloaca, that is the common chamber, is there. So this is about the alimentary canal or digestive system of the birds. Then respiratory system. See here, this is the respiratory system. These are the lungs. Okay, two lungs are there. These are the bronchi and this is the trachea. So trachea, then two bronchi, and these are the two large lungs. Now these lungs are connected to these air bladders. So this structure is air bladder. So air bladder plus lungs, they provide fresh air to the birds, because in the birds metabolic rate is high. And that's why oxygen demand is also high. So the lungs as well as air bladder, they supply high amount of oxygen. Circulatory system, rapid metabolism requires large amount of oxygen. So the circulatory system is also well developed. Avian heart is large size. Actually that specific term is used to define the large shaped heart, that is tachycardia. Tachycardia means the heart is large in size. So avian heart, normally or genetically, the avian heart is large size. It is powerful and it is efficient. In the circulation or in the birds, double circulation takes place. Means the heart receives blood for twice. So that is known as blood double blood circulation. Then the heart is four chambered. Large amount of hemoglobin is present in the RBCs. So all these features, they are helpful for the flight, because during the flight, the birds, they need a lot of energy. So all these things, they support the energy. Actually, they support to produce the energy, lot of energy. Then excretory system. In the excretory system of birds, urinary bladder is completely absent. No urinary bladder, because what is the function of the urinary bladder? In the urinary bladder, urine is stored for some time. So the body becomes heavyweight. So to avoid that, here urinary bladder is absent. They secrete the semi-solid urine. Okay, semi-solid urine means their excreta, means minimum amount, they are uricotelic. Uricotelic means they excrete uric acid. And this uric acid, it needs less amount of water for the excretion. And that's why their excreta is semi-solid. So no urinary bladder, they are uricotelic and they excrete semi-solid excreta. So it reduces unnecessary weight. Then the next is, this is the heart picture. The heart is four chambered, completely four chambered. These are